The defense has rested and without any of the anticipated possible testimony from Cate Edwards, John Edwards, or Rielle Hunter, the other woman in this saga. The closing arguments are set here for tomorrow, and the jury begins its deliberations on Friday. Now, as you read the story on the page around me here, keep in mind some of the complicated questions this jury might have to grapple with. Here is an example. Today, there was a stipulation read to the jury. That is just an agreement from both sides on some basic facts. And the fact here was that the Edwards-Hunter pregnancy could be confirmed on June 3rd, 2007. Now, that could be seen as discrediting the testimony of Sherry Young. She, of course, along with her family and her husband, went into hiding with Rielle Hunter. Sherry Young testified here that Rielle Hunter told her she was pregnant and showed her a medical document a full month before that June 3rd date. So, June 3rd, the pregnancy can be confirmed. However, the bunny money checks begin on June 5th. That doesn't leave Andrew Young any of the time he testified about to go to Mrs. Hunter to ask for the beginning of what turned out to be $725,000. That money, of course, is at the very crux of this campaign finance violation trial here. What does it all mean? Well, the jury could decide that Sherry Young is lying, or they could decide that the mystery woman, Rielle Hunter, lied about being pregnant, then got pregnant, and then began her odyssey across the country, living life in luxury hotels and flying around on private jets, all financed by her lover's wealthy supporters. This is just one of the complicated questions, so I predict it won't be a quick verdict, but I'll be here on Verdict Watch.